Good morning, students. Today we are going to start a new lesson in EVS, lesson number 5, Understanding Time. Kids, time has three parts. What has gone by is the past. What is going on now is the present. What is yet to come is the future. Today is Wednesday. The word today shows the present time. Tomorrow is my birthday. The word tomorrow shows the future. Yesterday, Granny told me a story. The word yesterday shows the past. Time can be understood using means such as calendars, school timetables, etc. Do you know, children? It is important to understand time for studying history. Sometimes old statues, coins, shards of pottery, etc. are found while digging the foundation of a building. Kids, these things are studied carefully. Through these studies, we come to know about the period of time to which they belong. It is quite interesting to study these things. Today's newspaper becomes old tomorrow. But if we cannot remember a particular fact or a particular news, we search through old newspapers to find the information we need. You know what this means? This means that today's newspaper will tomorrow become an important means of getting to know history. Interesting, right? Can you tell how do we measure time? To measure time, we divide it into seconds, minutes, hours, day and night, fortnight. Fortnight means a period of 2 weeks, month, year. In this way, time can be measured. There are certain objects to measure time. What are those objects known as? Water clocks, clocks, and the calendar are instruments of measuring time. In the 14th century, the hourglass came into use in Europe. Europe is name of a country. It consisted of two connected glass vessels fitted in a wooden frame. Dry fine sand was poured into one of the vessels. The connecting hole between the vessels allowed the sand in the top vessel to fall into the lower vessel. The hourglass was constructed in such a way that it took 1 hour for all the sand to fall from one vessel into the other. The clock was then turned over as soon as all the sand had fallen into the lower vessel. This is how a period of 1 hour was measured. These clocks were used in India too. Now, children, try this. Stick photographs of yourself from the past when you were a small kid and present in your book. Present now how you look. Stick photographs of your baby when you were a baby, then now how you look. And one picture you are going to draw of the future, what you are going to look like in 20 years. So now this is going to be fun. Go ahead and do it. Stick photographs when you were a baby, now how you look like, and an imaginary drawing of how you are going to look like after 20 years. Can you tell, children? Why do we make partitions of time in different ways? Kids, for convenience of everyday work, time is divided in different ways. For example, while using words like now, a while ago, in a while, or today, yesterday, and tomorrow, we are unknowingly measuring time in our minds. Now let us revise what we have learned. For convenience of day-to-day work, time is split into parts. When we use words like right now, in a while, or later, we unknowingly measure time in our minds. Time is measured by using instruments such as clocks, calendars, and school timetables. Time is divided into parts such as second, minute, hour, day and night, or week, fortnight, month, and year. We get an understanding of time through historical buildings or old objects like coins, statues, or shards of pottery found in an area. They help us to understand the history of that place.